Hello, my name is Tom, and I have the pleasure to demonstrate to you how easy it is to connect Grafana Cloud with ClickHouse Cloud in order to visualize data that is stored in a table in ClickHouse Cloud. In order to do that, I will first connect to a ClickHouse Cloud instance where I will create a brand new table that I will then load with some sample data that is hosted in AWS S3. And then I will go to Grafana Cloud. I will connect it to my ClickHouse Cloud instance. That will be a secure connection, TLS encrypted, so the data on transport is secured. And then I will create a dashboard with two panels where we create some visualizations of our sample data. Let's now start with the sample data. The data that I will use is the TLC trip record data. This is provided by the New York City Taxi and Limousine Commission. And basically, each record, each row in our table is representing one taxi trip in New York City where some passenger or passengers got picked up, drove a distance, and got dropped again. This data is provided in TSV format, tab-separated values, and we downloaded a copy of this data to our own AWS S3 bucket. And I just mentioned that this data is provided in TSV, tab-separated value format. This is no problem for ClickHouse. Here you can see the documentation for the natively supported input and output data formats of ClickHouse. You can see that TSV is supported by ClickHouse, but not just TSV. ClickHouse can natively understand for reading and writing pretty much each well-known data format. For example, CSV, JSON, XML, Protobuf, Afro, Parquet, and many more formats. Now I'm heading over to ClickHouse Cloud. I created a brand new service for this demo, and I'm seeing here the connection infos for the service. And what I'm going to do now, I copy my password and I'm connecting to the SQL console. I enter my password here to authenticate myself against my service. And now I'm going back to our tutorial that I mentioned before. And I copy the DDL query here in order to create a brand new table. I paste it here and I execute it. And voila, we have our table. Now I'm going back to the tutorial and also copy a query that will load some data into our table. Let's go back to our service, replace this DDL statement. And what I'm using here is the S3 table function provided by ClickHouse that you can use in order to load data that is stored in an AWS S3 bucket into ClickHouse. And yeah, we are going to do this now. Click the run button. That should be quite fast. And yes, all the data is loaded. Let's double check this. Let's check the count of our new table. And you can see that we have about 2 million rows in our table, yeah, representing about 2 million taxi trips in New York City. And now let's do a typical data analytics query in ClickHouse over this data. I have a query prepared that is calculating the average cost of a trip based on the number of passengers. Let's run this. And here you can see, for example, that the average cost for a trip with 6 passengers in the car is about $16. And so on. So now I will head over to Grafana Cloud in order to visualize our data. And what we will be using there is the official Grafana ClickHouse plugin. If you're interested in the details, quite recently there was a blog article published about this ClickHouse plugin for Grafana. And what is interesting to say is that this plugin is developed in cooperation between ClickHouse Incorporated and Grafana Labs. So we are working together to implement this plugin. Okay, so now here we have Grafana Cloud. I'm using a test version here. And the first thing we have to do, we go to settings and plugins and go to the search bar here and enter ClickHouse in order to find the official ClickHouse plugin by Grafana Labs. It's this one here, so we click on it. And now we click here in order to install it, which is super easy by clicking here on this install plugin button. Let's head back to Grafana and let's do a refresh of this browser page. And yes, it's installed. The next thing we have to do, now we have to create the ClickHouse data source that is connecting this Grafana Cloud instance to our ClickHouse Cloud instance. And what we have to do here, which is super easy, we are going back to ClickHouse Cloud instance. We are still seeing this screen showing all the connection infos. And the Grafana ClickHouse plugin is speaking the native protocol. And we just copy the host information from here, go back to our Grafana settings, enter the host address here. The port is not 9000, it's slightly different. It's 9440. So copy this one. And very important, we have to enable the secure connection slider here, because this is the only way how you can communicate with a ClickHouse Cloud instance. It's only possible via a TLS encrypted wire connection. Now we have to enter our credentials. We are using the default user. This is just for this demo purpose. In production, I would recommend to create a dedicated user, but we are using the default user for now. And I copy the password from here and enter it here. I think this is all we have to do. Let's save and test this connection. And yes, it's working. Perfect. Before we are going to create our own dashboard, I want to quickly show you something, because this ClickHouse plugin comes with ready-to-use monitoring dashboards for ClickHouse. I will quickly import these. And also these dashboards are developed together with ClickHouse, cooperation with us. And so yeah, let's quickly have a look. I open this quickly in tabs. So there's one ready-to-use dashboard for query analysis. You can see all the queries that are running on your instance, in this case on our cloud instance. Then there is a dashboard showing all kinds of information about the data stored in your ClickHouse instance. And there's also a dashboard taking a broadside perspective to the whole cluster, showing you what's going on there. Okay, I will close these tabs again, because this is not the focus of this demo. What we want to do, we want to create our own dashboard. And in order to do that, we head over to the dashboards part here and click on new dashboard, click on add a new panel. First thing I'm going to do here is to select our just configured ClickHouse data source. Then I'm switching over to the SQL editor here and I'm pasting a query that I prepared. I run this query. Let's switch to the tabular result view here. And what this query is doing, it's calculating the top three most popular pickup neighborhoods in New York City ordered by frequency in our dataset. And now we want to visualize this. What I really like about Grafana is the suggestions section here, where Grafana is kind of proactively suggesting visualizations that could match quite well with this tabular result. And I like this pie chart here, so let's edit. And maybe let's also give it a nice panel title, our favorite New York City pickup neighborhoods. I'm happy with that, so let's click on apply and boom, we have our first visualization. Let's add one more. So I'm clicking here, add a new panel. And again, I'm selecting the ClickHouse data source. Again, I'm selecting the SQL editor. And again, I have prepared the SQL query. This time, this query is calculating the geolocations for the top 10 pickup locations in New York City. And so This time I'm not using a suggestion to visualize it. Instead, I want to explicitly pick up my visualization, and I'm using a GeoMap panel to visualize this pickup locations. It's still beta, but it works. So let's click here. This time, maybe I start with the panel title. So our New York City pickup locations, and there's already a data layer prepared here. And my SQL query is delivering coordinates. We have a latitude field, which I called pickup latitude, and the longitude field is the pickup longitude. And we can already see that we have some points here. And if you are familiar with New York City, I think it kind of makes sense that these are popular pickup locations. What I also want to show you quickly is that you can use a different base map layer. I'm using the default base layer here, but you could also go to OpenStreetMap, or where is it? You can also use something like ArcGIS map server. And I like the default base layer, so we keep it like this. And what I also like is that you can store with this panel the default zoom level by just clicking on this use current map settings button. And yeah, I'm happy with that. Let's click to apply. And now we have a dashboard with two nice visualizations of our taxi ride data. Okay, and now as the last part of this demo, I want to show you briefly what happens behind the scenes, so to speak, when you have a dashboard visualizing data stored in ClickHouse. So we created the dashboard with two visualizations, with two panels. And whenever you update your dashboard, whenever you refresh your browser, or also, let's quickly go back to our dashboard, you can also configure the dashboard that it's automatically updating itself, let's say each 10 seconds. So whenever this happens, then the underlying SQL query for the visualization is sent to the ClickHouse table, and the result is sent back to Grafana, and then Grafana is rendering the data. And so when we have a dashboard with two panels, then whenever we refresh the dashboard, two queries are sent to ClickHouse, and yeah, two results are rendered. And we don't have time for this today, but maybe in another demo. What you also can do in Grafana dashboards, you can create filters for a dashboard. And also for a filter, you can send first a query to ClickHouse, maybe a group by query or a unique distinct query to get your values that you will use for filtering your dashboard. And then you can prepare the SQL queries of your visualizations in a way that when a specific value is selected in the filter, then automatically the SQL query for your panel is extended with an appropriate where predicate. Yeah, and then when you select the filter value, all your visualizations are also filtered accordingly. Another thing you can do, you can create a time filter for the whole dashboard. For example, you can select show me the data from the last 6 hours. This of course requires that your data, that your table rows have a column representing time. And if you have that, then you can also prepare your SQL queries in a way that whenever there is a time span selected here, then you have automatically a where predicate filtering on your time column. So thank you very much for listening to this short demo. I hope you learned something and you could see how easy it is to connect Grafana Cloud with ClickHouse Cloud. Until next time, bye.